Hi everyone, welcome. My name is Grace Perkle. I am a part of the Towson University Early Childhood and Special Education Program. Thank you for joining me today as we think about what we wear makes us glow. This is an integrated arts activity about the representation of your clothes to make you feel like the best version of yourself. This is geared towards pre-K students and the academic area of literacy. Today, we are going to read a book called Annie's Plaid Shirt by Stacey Davids and illustrated by Rachel Balsatis. After we read, you'll have the most amazing opportunity to complete a super fun arts activity with your family. So who's ready to read? Annie's Plaid Shirt. Annie loved her plaid shirt. She went to school in her plaid shirt. She went to parties in her plaid shirt. She painted in her plaid shirt. Annie did everything in her plaid shirt. But one day, Annie's mom said, "Let's go to the mall. Tomorrow's Uncle Betty's wedding. Your brother needs a new suit and you need a nice dress." "I'll be wearing my plaid shirt," said Annie. "Oh no," Mom said, "it looks like an old tablecloth. You must wear a dress to the wedding." "Absolutely not," said Annie. "I'm wearing my plaid shirt." "We'll see," said Mom. At the mall, Mom bought Albert a new suit. "Annie," she said, "will you at least try on some dresses for me? Maybe you'll find one you like." "Yeesh," replied Annie. "Please just this one time." "Okay, fine," Annie pouted, "if I have to." Annie tried on lots of dresses. They all felt wrong. "Please," Mom begged, "just one more." Annie saw the hopeful look on her mom's face. She agreed to try on just one more. "It's perfect," said Mom. "You look beautiful." When they arrived home, Annie ran to her room and slammed the door. She wished her mom understood her. Annie felt weird in her dresses. She was happiest when she wore her plaid shirt. Why couldn't her mom see that? "Why can't Annie wear what she wants to wear?" asked Albert. "I want Annie to be herself, but I'm worried about what other people will think," Mom said. "Little girls always wear dresses to weddings." The next morning, they all rushed to get ready for the wedding. Annie frowned at the dress. Then she had an idea. Mom wondered what was taking the kids so long. She started to worry. "I should have let Annie wear her plaid shirt," she thought, but it was too late. "Come on, kids," she called. "We have to leave now." Annie and Albert giggled and yelled, "Be right there." "Well," said Annie, "what do you think?" "It's perfect," said Mom. "You look so beautiful." "Of course," said Annie. "I'm wearing my plaid shirt." The end.
I loved that book. This book is about being yourself and wearing something that makes you feel happy and puts a smile on your face. In this case, Annie loved her plaid shirt. She felt like her best when she wore it, and it's okay to be yourself, even if it's different. As I'm here talking to you guys, I'm wearing my favorite shirt, Towson. I wear it, every time I wear it, it reminds me of how I should be proud of myself, that I have this amazing opportunity to be sitting, talking to you guys, and one day become a teacher from everything I'm learning at Towson University. Go Tigers! So, the craft I would love for you guys to do today is create an item, a clothing item, that makes you glow. You can draw this, you can use a whole bunch of different materials. So, I have some examples for you, and I will give you a list of different materials you can use. So, to begin, I have this one. Pink is my favorite color, so that is why I'm wearing pink in this drawing. Every time I wear it, it makes me feel confident. In this one, you can use outside materials. So this is some leaves. I liked the texture, I liked the color. This one, when I was younger, I did dance classes and ballet, so this reminded me of the red tutu I always wore. So you can create, you can use this using anything. All you need mostly is any coloring utensil. You can use crayons, you can use markers, you can use colored pencils, you can use glitter, even though that could get a little messy, but still a lot of fun. You can use pom-poms, outside materials, like I said. So you have leaves, sticks, twigs, yarn. If you want to add some hair, you can use flowers, glue to paste everything. So anything you have at the home, you can use. So have fun creating your favorite clothing item. This could be a shirt, this could be a dress, this could be shoes, it could be shorts, skirt, anything. So this craft is unique for you of what you wear that makes you glow. Thank you so much for reading a story with me today, and I hope you have fun making your amazing, amazing craft.